Like many countries, Turkey has long tradition of street dogs. Dogs that live near people but not with people. Dogs that live on scraps and handouts with no owners and no permanent mailing address. However, in recent years, stray dogs are being captured off the streets of Istanbul and dumped in the forest. How do these poor dogs survive? On Facebook, I discovered that several groups cared for these dogs. I arranged to meet with one group in Istanbul, at this cafe, and they took me to see the dogs. Coming from space, this is the way to the dream forest. We went by car to see the dogs. It's about a 45-minute drive. Ramazan began visiting the forest 5 years ago when he heard that over 1,000 dogs had been dumped there and needed help. The dogs were in danger of starving to death. Some dogs were being attacked or even poisoned. With a few friends, Ramazan went out on Sundays to feed the dogs. They purchased old bread from bakeries and collected food donations.
Gel oğlum, gel, gel, gel, gel, gel, gel, gel, yavaşla biraz daha. Gel, gel, gel, gel. Tamam, geliyor, yavaş yavaş kayalım.
He told me that he eventually organized a group of volunteers to feed and protect the dogs. He opened a Facebook page and named the group Huysuz Ihtiyar. In English, it means a grumpy old dog. He named the group after an old dog that he admired, who disappeared one day. He never saw the dog again. Cars and trucks are one of the biggest threats to the dogs. Dogs swarm the road looking for food and human friends. The team of volunteers visits the Beykoz forest outside Istanbul to feed and care for between 800 to 1200 stray dogs. Most members work during the week, so Sunday is the main day for checking on the dogs. Along with food, the group brings large tanks of water for the dogs. Most of these dogs come from neighborhoods in Istanbul. When someone complains about street dogs, city officials capture them. Ideally, the dog is given its shots fixed and a registration tag is attached to its ear. Each color represents a neighborhood. The dog should then be returned safely to its own neighborhood. However, many of these dogs are being dumped in the forest. Some owners also abandon their pets in the forest and drive away. Irresponsible dog breeders dump unwanted dogs out here as well. When the group finds newly abandoned dogs, they take them to the Beykoz shelter where they are checked and fixed if need be. The dogs form packs and sometimes there can be fights with outsiders who intrude on their territory. Pebbles followed her human friends into a different pack area. The local dogs check her out suspiciously. She stays cool and calm and ends the encounter with a smile. These forests are government property. Ramazan said that initially the government tried to stop them from helping the dogs. The group persisted and eventually negotiated an agreement. For now, officials allow them to feed and care for the dogs. On Saturday evenings, the group starts preparing the food for Sunday. Some members drive to restaurants and food companies to collect leftovers and out-of-date food. Other people cook pots of pasta with chicken stock. This can be mixed with scraps and canned dog food to make a delicious doggy banquet. On their Facebook page, the group encourages people to bring children. The vast majority of the dogs are gentle with adults and kids. They put up with all kinds of indignities from their human friends. The group does its best to stay on good terms with the public and officials. They try to persuade people that the dogs deserve kindness and humane treatment. Here I am with a puppy that I wanted to take home to California. However, it's traumatic and expensive to put dogs through quarantines and long jet flights. So it is best to find them homes in Turkey if possible. Yadigar is in charge of much of the medical care. She's very experienced treating the dogs, and she does a great job. This dog had skin lacerations that needed medicating. It also has an eye infection, so it gets the full medical treatment. The dogs are amazingly tolerant to all this poking and prodding.
Evet. Hoş geldin.
Oradan geri döndük ama.
Neyse doğru yolu bulduk. Sorunumuz yok o zaman.
Some of the vitamins and drugs are donated. The group also buys medication out of their own budget.
Dedim ama şeyde
tamam. Polinizden çıkınca ilk saat burası.
Arkadaşlar köpekleri alıyorsunuz, bırakmıyorsunuz.
Gel, ne oldu?
The dogs are regularly treated for parasites and given vitamins to boost their immune system.
şey yapmış. Hayır. İlaç
vermiş bana. Tamam, o zaman bırakıyoruz. Tamam, şu siyah kaldı sadece. O siyahı getirin yeter. Kaçacak bir
şey. Living near the road is a risk for dogs. Speeding cars and trucks injure and kill many dogs. One of the saddest responsibilities of the group is burying dogs that have been killed. If cars slow down, it is much safer. Many don't slow down. Ramazan tries to persuade the truck drivers to stay on the appropriate roads. He talks with them politely, but many don't care. This driver was not happy with my video camera. It is a constant struggle to keep the dogs safe. Seeing an injured dog that is nervous, Yadigar tries to reassure it. Ramazan and the group have faced hostility at times. Some people dislike the dogs. They want to see them run off or killed. Building dog houses is very important to keep the dogs safe and healthy. They can freeze to death without shelter during the icy winters. The group always needs people who can help with construction. At another stop, Yadigar and Gonca found a very sick dog. Yadigar calls for help. Extremely sick or injured dogs are usually taken to the Beykoz shelter for care. If that isn't possible, the group takes them to the vet and pays for their treatment. Most of the budget comes from donations. Dogs are injured in fights. Dogs die from old age illness and exposure to cold and heat. Sometimes new dogs disappear and are never seen again. One day, the dogs alerted us to something shocking. Someone had chained a dog to a post. The poor dog is freed from the pole on chains. What kind of person did this?
Şu çok küçük bir kap buradan kavga çıkar.
Yani. Ben diyemem.
Other people go to butcher shops to collect bones. Butcher shops throw away a lot of uncooked chicken bones, and these are great for the dogs. Ramazan estimates that 80% of the butchers will contribute bones and meat scraps for free, just to help out. He believes that many Turkish people have a good heart and can be persuaded to help the dogs. The group takes 1 ton of water to the forest each week to help the dogs during the hot and dry months. The dogs get a big variety of food, including pasta, milk, meat scraps, and bones. They also eat a lot of dry and canned dog food. A few people go out on weekdays to check on the dogs. Yadigar and Gonca often go out during the week to drop off food. The main challenge is keeping all the dogs fed and nourished with good, healthy food. Ideally, the dogs could find safe homes with good families. It's difficult to find people to adopt most of the older and larger dogs, but the group works hard to find homes for puppies and young dogs.
Hay Allah'ım kuzuşum ya.
Çok güzelsiniz.
Bak bak bak bak içeride içeride.
Bırak aç kalmasın bırak.
Ay.
Yani.
Bu benimki.
The puppies are all cute, so they have an advantage. The group encourages people to adopt these dogs and not buy from puppy mills or pet shops that are only concerned with making money. These dogs are going to real homes.
Bak bakayım bana, bak bak bak bak. Oğlum, oğlum.
Geç,
geç, geç, geç.
Denizli'ye yolluyorum. Denizli'den iyi sahiplendiriyoruz, iyi yerlere sahiplendiriyoruz.
This is a real dog town because there are so many houses and dogs in one place. The large Beykoz dog shelter is right next door too. A few years earlier, Ramazan went to the forest during the winter. He found 50 dogs frozen to death. After that, they began building dog houses. On their Facebook page, Ramazan asked for people to help build houses. Many people volunteered. So far, Huysuz Ihtiyar has built 250 houses for 800 or so dogs. With winter houses, the dogs can survive the bitter cold. Many dogs are treated medically inside the shelter. Then dogs are released outside when they are healthy. Some people are afraid of all these dogs, but they are not aggressive. They are just excited to see their human friends. Unfortunately, people sometimes destroy the houses. In some areas, they are not allowed to build anything for the dogs. In Turkey, pet owners are obsessed with purebred dogs. Owners want trendy breeds that are in vogue to show off to their neighbors. Street mutts are not welcome. Ramazan complains that this is foolish. The so-called mixed breed dogs are healthier, smarter, and make better pets than highly inbred dogs. Many so-called purebred dogs have genetic problems and neurotic temperaments. Truly, the main danger is that they knock you down in their excitement to be your best friend. The next thing you know, you are on the ground looking up, trying to figure out what happened. The ultimate goal of Huysuz Ihtiyar is to find an area with 25 fenced acres where all the dogs can be cared for properly. They hope to persuade the government to help. The fear is that the forests will be cut down for development, and then the dogs will have nowhere to go. The group hopes to educate the Turkish public, to reach their hearts and convince them that these dogs deserve respect and protection. They wish everyone would join with them in saving the dogs of the dream forest.